How's it going, everyone? Welcome to Best Ball with Bindles. We are here with El Coach. We are going to rip a biggest board. And there's nothing a ton going on in the news right now. No free agency, no big rookie news. So just vamp a little bit. So if you have any bullets left in the biggest board, jump in with us and let's get started. GM, how's it going, El Coach? How has your week been so far? And you ready to spend $100 in March on a 2024 football team?
Let's get after it. Last weekend in March. Let's push in some chips and have a little fun with the biggest board. I'm told that nicer weather is on deck. Started loosening up the golf swing, just kind of, you know, slowly coming out of hibernation. So I think we're good, man. How you been?
Yeah, pretty good. Just had a very relaxing weekend. The sack video has been popping off, so that was cool to kind of just watch it blow up. So thanks to everyone for tuning in for that one. It's been good so far. Just kind of chill week so far.
Yeah, good stuff. We've got some new kickoff rule changes.
Yeah, what are your thoughts on that? I feel like, and best ball guy in the chat is saying Cordarrelle Patterson to the Steelers are immediately trying to capitalize.
The Art Smith reunion, I'm here for it. I think it's cool that the kickoffs were kind of becoming just a complete non-event at that point. I think I saw something to where it was around 20% of them were actually able to be returned last year. And anytime you've got something it's got like an 80% fail rate, you know, you're not getting above the Mendoza line at that 200 there to get them going. I think it's time to have it looked at and get it changed. I think it's cool. The NFL was kind of swift like that and got it done fast. And, you know, we've got something else to look forward to this year.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be different. It's like technically not permanent, right? Like they said, like they're going to try it out and see what happens. But I feel like it's a good move. Like maybe some more action, probably better for the players as well. Like less crazy collisions and stuff. So I don't know. I guess prioritize a kick returner. So like the Steelers are cutting edge right there, getting Cordarrelle Patterson. Do you remember Devin Hester? I think he's more of a punt returner, but that was must watch TV. I remember as a kid, just absolutely electric. So maybe we need some more kick return specialists. Maybe this will prioritize that.
Yeah. We'll never forget the opening kickoff of Super Bowl 41, when he just did a house call, against the Colts. That was pretty great. Was slightly nervous after that, but then Rex Grossman started playing and felt better about things when the QB matchup is Rex Grossman versus Peyton Manning. It was nice.
Dude, that was a crazy – the Rex Grossman, like, making it that far. Like, that was a different era, though. Like, that was very much like run up the middle, just, like, have 250-pound linebackers. I remember Brian Urlacher. Just like that was like my idol as a kid, like Jerome Bettis and Brian Urlacher, just absolute units. You know what? Actually, I have a Jerome Bettis jersey. Let me throw it on. Give me 1 second. Let me go off camera.
The bus.
Let's pull up the draft board. Let's see. We still are waiting two more. So if anyone still has any biggest board bullets left and they want to rip $100, please jump in with us.
Let's get after it. Yeah, I loved. That was fun with Rex Grossman back then because you had Bernard Berry and just running those clear out go routes downfield relentlessly. And Rex would have it in him once or twice a game. Just cut one loose, unleash the dragon, throw it downfield. He's got to be open down there somewhere. They were definitely a fun team to watch around that time frame. So the surprise Super Bowl run on the back of that legendary defense, and Colts kind of caught fire on defense in the playoffs too with healthy Bob Sanders coming back. That was too much fun.
We got the classic Jerome Bettis jersey from Super Bowl XL in Detroit, and I'm from Detroit, so you know, it's a classic. I am a Lions fan, but you know, as a Lions fan, you always have to have your second team because they were so. This was around the time when they went 0-16. Like, it's just a very dark time in Detroit sports history. And my neighbor was from Pittsburgh and he was a big Steelers fan, so he got me as my second, you know, backup team, the Steelers. So,
man, you know, honestly, one of the more despicable things I've ever heard. But whatever. Was that the Hines Ward Super Bowl?
Yeah, the Hines Ward. Antoine Randall L. Yeah. Young Big Ben.
Yeah, that was another fun like Colts postseason meltdown game.
Oh my God! Yeah, that was the Jerome Bettis. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, they knocked the ball out at like the 1 yard line, and then Big Ben tackles like I think it was like Nick Harper or something like by the ankle, and then Vanderjack missed the 40 yard something kick.
All righty, so we filled. Here we go.
Hey, okay. Look at that, 107.
I like it. I feel like there's some. I feel like any of the top 7 or 8 picks, I feel pretty good with. So yeah. The real question is do we piss in the $100 draft or do we go alpha and take some running backs? Because I feel like we'll have probably both available. Bijan's. What about Bijan getting pushed up above Jefferson? I feel like that's jumping the shark.
Crazy pills. I still, you know, my stance on it. I can't abide Jefferson, much less Jefferson going past like 105, 106. Like I get the argument around CMC and Tyreek to a certain extent, but yeah, this is, and now you're just confusing people in the chat that are tuning in for the first time and they think we got like a Yinzer running the show. This is terrifying.
You know what? I will, I'll just do it as an homage to our boy, Nez from the Badge Bros. I'll just say it's for that. Okay.
Love it. Anybody else in here that you know?
Yeah, I think Rusty's in here with us. Let's see. Yeah, Rusty's at 11. Yep. Is there anybody else? Bagels, I don't recognize. The Man. Oh, Gobbler. Yeah, Gobbler's in here. He's from the Ship Chasing Discord. I think he said he was waiting. I think he was waiting when I pinged in the Ship Chasing Discord. So I think we got some sharps. I mean, $100 draft, right? You're probably more likely to get some sharps in here. So that's okay. You know, we've been practicing. You can be on the top of our game.
I feel like we used up all of our bad luck last week. So let's get after it.
Yeah. Something was in the air. Something was in the water last week. I don't know what the hell is happening, but you know what? We got it out. We purged it out of our system. Oh, wait, is that Eagles? Oh, no, it's Bagels. I thought it was Eagles. It's the same because it's three Z's. It's exactly the same.
Throws me off.
Yo, do you know Eagles on Twitter and whatnot? No,
I don't. Really? I've been in some drafts though.
He is like the OG of all. Okay, we're about to be on the clock, so let me finish my Eagles vamping.
I think we want to do the same thing here, right?
Do we want you want Amon-Ra? Just say rip it.
Yeah, I would like, you want to do Amon-Ra or?
Let's do Amon-Ra.
Yeah, we haven't, I don't think we've got him yet this year. Let's do it. Cool. It's my game, all my thugs. Rolling hands if it's showing some love. And from the Detroit City. I said go from the Detroit City. Every place, everywhere we go. Man, we deep everywhere we roll.
Oh, and it's on a loop. Okay, so we're going Detroit heavy. Maybe we can get a Sam Laporta coming back to us at 31. Let's rip it.
Very spicy. Yeah. Brees going right there. It's nice. And then Puka.
So Rusty's got Bagels, definitely his burner.
It's like a Philly versus New York thing, right? Eagles versus Bagels. It's good.
Yeah. No, absolutely. Eagles. So like I think I started drafting. I don't know what the first year underdog came out. If it was 20, I always forget if it's 2020. I think it was 2020, not 2021, but I wasn't really doing tournaments because I just, my brain had not wrapped around the fact like of just spending money and just losing it. So I was just doing like $10 or like whatever, like 12 man leagues. And I would just see, I was like, who is this Eagles guy? He's in every fucking draft. And he's just a grinder, man. He just grinds. He used to be a very heavy RB guy, and now he's like finally coming around. But shout out to Eagles. He's one of the OGs in the underdog game, and I just, you know, definitely inspired me to become a grinder. So
love it. So are you ready to get down with some misinformation and break ADP here?
Yeah.
I don't want to jinx it, but you know, there's a certain player we've, damn it. I jinxed it.
That's okay. I feel like there's some guys here. Like, do you want to do Achan or Marvin Harrison?
I am down for Achan.
Do we take one running back detour and then try to yep. make it up after?
Let's make it hard on ourselves. And
the only thing is, if we want Laporta, then we should take a wide receiver.
I can wait on Laporta. I don't think I would rather have Achan than Laporta.
Okay. Yeah. I feel like this is a very hot start. I like it. Amon-Ra. I was talking to Sacrilegious about the Sortino ratio and kind of like the floor ceiling combo. And Amon-Ra is like, people think of him as a floor guy, but he's like, he really gives you the best mix of both. Yeah. Like, he's never going to bust, and he's also going to give you some, well, I don't know about in half PPR. I always get my half PPR and full PPR because I usually play full PPR in Dynasty, but like, whatever, 25 point games, I guess, in half PPR.
Yeah, it's like the Jalen Hurts of wide receivers, man. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
He's just so consistent. Like, he's going to get 10 targets every single game. And targets go burr. So,
yeah. No, this is great. You've been on the forefront of pumping Achan quite a bit this off season. So, I think it's a good spot to finally pull the trigger and get him here mid second. So,
I feel like that's pretty nice price. Like 18. It's, I don't know where I just feel like Saquon. I do think. He will get more touchdowns than previous Eagles running backs. And we were talking about touch push efficiency, and I've seen some hot takes on both sides. But so I think he'll get more touchdowns, but like, he's not going to catch that many passes, right? So like, even if he does go nuclear on the touchdowns, that's still only like one half of the equation for like running backs that we really, really want. So I don't know.
I mean, touchdowns are the one that you, if you're going to go nuts on, like those are the one that, like the one that goes for 6 points is really fun to go nuts on. Like Raheem Mostert pretty like just, you know, absolutely carried some teams last year when you kind of pick up that unexpected spike. I think everybody's kind of like baking that in hardcore with Barkley. So I almost feel like he'd have to overperform from a touchdown perspective. Yeah.
It just seems, I don't know. It just seems a little bit pricey for what that is going to be. Like, I think Jacobs is going to get pushed up into the second round, probably. Derrick Henry will probably get pushed up like 2-3 turn, probably around where he was going last year, maybe higher. I feel like once the general public gets in here, I think they'll probably push up Derrick Henry on the Ravens, right? Like that seems like that'll happen, but I'm interested. We got Steph in the chat. Shout out to Steph. Okay, so I don't think a Weakland 71 is in the chat. So what are we thinking here?
What I am thinking is I would really like to build out a Dolphin stack here, or we've got a falling Debo and we can kind of lean into the spike week guys.
Yeah. I mean, I think Waddle makes sense as a tiebreaker. But Debo is the ADP value, but I feel like Waddle and Debo, like, realistically, are they that different? Like, I don't think so. Okay, let's go. Do you want Waddle or Neighbors?
That's the other. I like that we can. I like building out what we can here. I think having the correlation is good. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it makes sense. We already took Achan, so let's make a little Miami bet. I think that makes sense.
Do you have any triumphant dolphin noises that you can play?
I don't. You know what? I wish I did. That's I haven't been on my soundboard game the last couple drafts. I'm going to be completely honest. I need to work on that. So I will get in the lab and I will add some dolphin noises.
Bro, fitting that we are parked next to the man here, because this is about as high testosterone of a start as you can get with Breece Hall, Jonathan Taylor, and Sam Laporta. Bro.
Who is the man? Please reveal yourself.
Is it Dan Campbell just ripping?
We need what he's having. Right? Speaking of tea pills, he must be just fucking pounding the tea pills. Did you see the NFL coaches picture, like the group picture? And people were just making jokes about like January 6th and like all this different shit. And I was just dying. Like all those guys. I'm like, we are in the TRT era right now. Like,
yeah, I love it. And then Andy Reid just chilling in his Aloha shirt. Just he's evergreen.
Like, he's like, I'm going to go get some barbecue.
I love it, man. He's so just, you know, he's the best. I love it. And Dan Campbell, like, taking up, like, the spot of, like, two humans, basically, with the shoulders and the traps. Just ready to roll, man.
Oh, Ben R. says he's in the 12. And Steph was saying he's got some tea as well. Ben, are you taking tea pills? You got a little secret you want to tell us about?
Let's see what we got here. Oh, Jameer and Kyron, DK and Cooper, the grown men.
I mean, he's it's okay. He's making up for it. Okay, so we are on the clock here. Do we want to go receiver or do we want to go? I feel like we're gonna I think we can take one more detour if we really want to and go. Or yeah, you want to go Lamar and then try to get Flowers to come back around.
Yeah, I think we've got a couple of ways we can party on the way back.
Okay. Okay, I think we have to take receiver now.
Yeah. Look at this, just getting detoured all over the place to start.
Oh yeah, tragic. I don't think Flowers is going to come back to us, but we have some other options. But then we're really going to have to, make up for it.
Yeah, nothing like putting pressure on ourselves. It's good. Looks like Gary, in the two spot, is the only one committed to the Wiz, which is admirable. I appreciate it. Love to see it.
Let's see, what other teams do we have? We got Gobbler with the CMC, Rashee Rice, Mike Evans. So maybe setting up a little Patrick Mahomes stack later on. Maybe some, I wonder if Marquise Brown gets pushed up all the way to like this range right here. If people are going to try to stack Mahomes and Marquise Brown. Cause I mean, he's getting steamed pretty hard and I can see that keeping, continuing up. So I wonder.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a little rich, for my
I think
blood.
It's a little rich for me too. Yeah.
I know you and I have sung the praises of Hollywood over the years. He's at his best for your team when you can get him as a value. When you've, you know, perfect. Whew. It's hot. All right. So we lost Zay there, which is a
yeah, I figured that was going to happen. Yeah. These wide receivers are going to get, they're going to get ripped off the board. So we better, Amari Cooper. I feel like he's not going to, so let's go, let's think about it here. Rome, Pickens, Reed, McLaurin. I mean, I almost feel like, I was talking about the Sortino ratio. Like, we kind of need some innings eater type guys since we only have two wide receivers. So I wouldn't mind. Obviously, Rome, if he falls to us, I would definitely take him. Terry, I don't love Terry, but I feel like he's a little bit more consistent. But
so
I guess we have other guys coming back around. So
fully out on Andrews here because of what it'll do to our structure.
I don't think we can. I don't think we can swing it.
Yeah.
Because I mean, pull up the board. Like, where are our next picks? Like, I feel like we're gonna get.
You go 55 and 66, so it starts to get pretty speculative there.
I mean, I feel like this room is pretty. I guess Rome is falling this far, but so it's not. I guess it's not particularly crazy.
Yeah. If it gets to us, well, the guy after us only has one receiver too. So yeah, I would be down for Rome.
I feel like if Rome falls, we got to take Rome.
Yeah. Where do you go between pick? Yeah. Wow. All right.
I feel like we got to go Rome.
Mr. Christmas Tree, reception perception.
Yeah. That was crazy. This wide receiver class is absolutely nuts.
Like, dude,
doesn't even make sense to me. Like,
I've had to like just put the phone down for like dynasty trades because like I'm so over eager for the draft to get here that I just want to like get stuff now, and I'm like, I just need to pump the brakes.
Yeah, I think I'm like every like I said, like I think in the past I've been the guy who's like trading away my picks for veterans like early on, and like I'm just same thing. Like I'm just like, okay, just put the phone down, walk away. Like, yeah. Wait at least to the rookie draft so you're on the clock. And then someone's going to – if you're hype, someone else is hype as well. So you can probably sell them for even more, right? Like, we know the dynasty cycle thing that we see getting passed around all the time. But, yeah, man, it's hard to trade those picks right now. Like, the rookie hype is at an all-time high.
Ridiculous.
And Andrews went right after us. I was going to say there was a small chance, very small chance, but I was like, maybe if
guys
are like this guy has Laporta, this guy has Kelce's, right? So really it's three guys. They probably would have taken him, right? But there was a chance.
Yeah. Yeah. But I think that was, it's not an easy, you know, click, but you know, we've done it to ourselves enough times where we didn't stay committed to the build. And when you start having to talk yourself into some of those wide receivers in like 9 and 10.
And I mean, look at this right now, right? We have one wide receiver on the queue right now. So that's,
yeah,
it's classic.
Now I do. I'm actually down to get. I don't know. What are you thinking for our next one here?
One sec. Let me just hit some of these. Yeah, working sucks. We need to win the BBM 5 just so I can watch streams and draft all day. I mean, that's already what I do. So, I mean, but yes, to be 100% into that. Let's see.
All right, so we are up. We've got Lamar, Achan, Amon-Ra.
I'm feeling Deontay.
Really?
I just think he's going to get so much volume. I don't know. I know I'm the Deontay bull. I would be fine with Godwin.
You know what? I'm down for it.
I mean,
it's line. Yeah,
we got to get our guys in this kind of draft. I just feel like he gives us such a. He's just going to get peppered. Speaking of guys with getting 10 targets a game, like he's going to get 10 targets a game. Like, I don't care if.
How do you say that a receiver is going to get a full load?
I need the bonk. I need the Spags bonk.
Yeah.
For myself as well. I've been the one who's been with the horny talk on, not unintentionally, but
the horny talk.
Let's see. What else do we have? Coach did not start his channel, but it is coming soon. We're gonna be cooking that up, and he's working.
Coming in May, should be good. The things I'm doing to Canva right now, it's a real shame. AI deserves better.
Yo, the one day when I was working, I forget what it's called, the OpenAI one or the whatever. There's one AI where I was trying to make the Lions like background. I literally got sucked. I was like, I can't touch this again because I literally wasted literally a whole day. Like, I was just putting in prompts just for like 8 hours straight. I was just like, okay,
yeah,
it's already happening. I can't fall into the matrix. Please don't suck me in and just leave me alone, please. So I was like, okay, I can't do this anymore. So no, even though it was so cool. Like I was just, especially like some of the prompts, it's very random, obviously still, but some of them were turning out very well. So
the entertainment factor alone for it is great. I was working like around some a gator chilling poolside, just great stuff. I mean, and you want to talk about some box gator chilling poolside with a beverage, some of those gator tails, some real dong energy, man, just like flopping out into the pool. Totally not safe. It was great.
Yeah, you got to do that on your personal computer. You can't have a gator tail dongs on there.
I'm going to apologize to the gator community for what what happened.
Your work IT is just going to be like, excuse me, sir. What are these? Yeah. What are you doing on this work computer?
Do you mind telling me about these series of these
gator dogs here? Okay, so we're going to be up on a few picks. We have JSN falling past ADP. I'm pretty fine with DeMont as our RB2 here.
Yeah.
We have four wide receivers, so I don't feel – I feel like we caught up decently. Wide receivers, other than that, it's rookies for a little bit, so I wouldn't be super jazzed with any of those guys. Let's see. We have another
flat. Yeah.
Who? So. I'm trying to think who. Okay. DeMont or Christian Watson? I feel like DeMont. I feel like it makes sense.
Yeah, especially with this. So that'll give us correlation, like two different stacks here. So I think that's.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. I would say it's. You want to do it? Okay. I love it, man. We're getting a good mix of Dolphins and your Lions here. It's fun.
Yeah, it's crazy because we were talking about with Sack on Friday. We were talking about kind of like using Sortino ratio and kind of how do you use that to build out your teams. And he was the combo that we were talking about was Achan and David Montgomery, because Achan's kind of like, right, he's going to have some games where he's not getting as many touches. He's not like a full bell cow where he does bust and he gets, you know, kind of a lower score from week to week. There's more variance there. And then David Montgomery is just as consistent as you get. Like he's never going to get below like 10 points. And then he still has contingent upside with Gibbs. And we know like the Jamal Williams role and then the DeMont role from last year, he can fall into the end zone three times any game. So gives you a very good combo of high floor and high ceiling. So.
Absolutely. All right. So we're going to be coming up at pick 90 here. Not real in love with any of the running backs that are there, so I would not have a problem reaching on a receiver. What do you think?
Who do we have at RB here?
Connor, Chubb, Eckler, Swift, Mostert, Javonte.
Yeah, I feel like probably receiver. What about tight end? Who do we have at tight end? Goddard, it's way past ADP. Okay, yeah, let's go receiver. Okay. You want to get some young supple receivers with Worthy or Mitchell? Who do you I think I prefer Worthy, honestly.
Brother. You good with it?
Yeah, let's do it.
Sometimes it just lines up. I feel like, wow, we really shook off the bad vibes from last week and we're just gliding down the stream. This is good.
Amen, brother. Yeah, I get A.D. Mitchell, like, physically just looks pretty insane, but his production was pretty bad. Like, all his peripherals don't look great. So I think I'm team Worthy over A.D. Mitchell. And I also feel like Worthy is – I guess they're both pretty likely to fall into that, like, late like 20 to 30 range, which are some good landing spots, like the Cowboys, like the Bills, like the Chiefs, right? So I guess landing spot will swing things a little bit, but I don't know. I don't feel great about AD Mitchell. It's not like I'm out on him. Like, I still want some exposure to him, but I just feel like we're the combo of being super fast and kind of having more production in his profile feels a little bit more. So feels a little.
Would you say he's one of those guys that's better in best ball too?
I mean, I would say, yeah, exactly. If he can give you rookies, we know kind of their production skews towards the end of the season anyways. And a guy who runs 4-2-1, if he catches a couple bombs, that feels pretty good. Not to say that AD Mitchell can't be that guy.
Yeah. Well, but. Bindles, you want to run through the team real quick? We haven't really talked about it before we come back up on the clock.
Yeah, of course. Okay, so we have a quarterback. We have two-time MVP Lamar Jackson. We have Devin Achan and David Montgomery. Shout out to Sacrilegious for the floor-ceiling combo of Achan and Montgomery. Then we have Amon-Ra St. Brown, the Detroit player. We got Jalen Waddle, Roma Dunes, Deontay Worthy, and no tight ends yet. So I feel like this is feeling pretty good. Only thing is going to be, who are we going to stack Lamar with? But I guess if you do have any quarterbacks that are unstacked, he feels like, right, because of the rushing upside, it's fine to not have a stack, but let's see what happens.
Yeah.
What else do we have here?
So I'm gonna start throwing some names in. What are you thinking? So we've got five wide receivers, so it's not imperative, but I also feel like it's a little bit of wish casting on part of Josh Downs, but Jacoby's probably the last like real target hog we're going to get in this range.
Yeah. I feel like, when's our next pick after this? I'm just trying to see.
114. And we
do we push Tua? Because where did Hill go? Cause he's on the other side of the board.
Yeah.
Right. So I feel like we can push Tua. Like, is anyone going to take an unstacked Tua? We have Achan and Waddle. I feel like we've got them. I prefer Myers personally, or Sutton, but I won't push back too much. If you like Downs over him, you go Downs over him.
We're gonna go Jacoby. We're gonna play the hits.
Okay. Yeah. I don't really have a strong lean there. Like, I just think, I don't know, man. Jacoby is just perennially underrated, and I feel like Downs is like, we want him to turn into what Jacoby is. I know the quarterback situation isn't amazing, but Gardner Minshew can slang it, and so can AOC. At least just beat him targets, right? We saw Pittman go absolutely crazy.
We did the thing. We did the thing where we talked ourselves into Deontay and Jacoby as values, because we took detours early. Like, that's real on brand. It's good stuff.
Let's see what else is going on. Yeah, we got hot naked Lamar doing yoga.
Mm. Little Beaker boy.
What else is going on? Yeah, Deontay with Bryce later on. Mm-hmm. I feel like we should probably smash that like, and I may show nip. That is true. If we
already lost one article of clothing with the Steelers jersey. Like, who's to say?
That's true. We don't have super chats, but I would do a very low amount for showing nip. I don't care.
That's the other Tuesday night show.
Yeah. That's after. That's real after dark.
Yeah. Goodness.
Okay, so let's see what's swinging around here for us. I feel like we take Tua if he falls. Don't want to jinx it.
Yeah.
Who knows what the man is going to do, because the testosterone is just flowing. He's not in control of his own body.
Let's see where bro is stacking up. He's got Keenan. He's got AR. I mean, he's fully, yeah. Speed merchants and rookies.
What about Goff? Where does Goff Where does Goff go? Because we might be able to
118. So we would be playing with fire.
118, but does anybody have a stack though? I mean, I feel like people are a little bit more likely to stay in their lanes in this. Oh, and Goff just went to the man.
Wow.
Okay. I say
it is Dan Campbell.
I say we go Tua for the stack. I think it makes sense.
All right.
Unless Tua, I mean, because what other stacking options do we have? Let's see. We have Bryce, but I feel like we just want to go three QBs probably. Troy Franklin or Goddard if you want, but it's up to you.
Yeah, I like Tua here. Let's do it.
Okay. I feel like for the stack, that makes sense. Bro, he has JMO. Okay.
Yeah, that's.
I feel like that's a kind of a weak stack.
Those three or four catches per game.
Oh, he has Laporta. Okay. So, okay. No, never mind. We'll stop playing him. He has Laporta. And
yeah.
Okay. Well, good. Okay. Well, we got one of our two stacks.
How did we talk ourselves into Lamar earlier? What did we do?
I mean, like.
Oh, because wide receiver was so gross. Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, I mean, we could have went Higgins or Amari Cooper.
Yeah, I think we did all right. Late round Bateman. That's where we go. I'm told that he's going to have a significant role in year four, right?
Hey, I actually don't hate him. I'm not going to lie. For whatever. What does he go? 18th round?
Yeah, something like that.
Okay, let's see what else we go. Yeah, 2023 week 17 correlation goes hard in March 2023. Yeah, it's still ingrained in our brains from last year from just watching so much and drafting so much that we're just getting the Miami-Baltimore stack still just ingrained in our brain, just burned in there.
I think Tyler is like hosting a lunch and learn in the chat. This is pretty great with Tanner.
About what?
Catching him up to date.
We really do need like a little like sheet that I can pull up on screen of be like, okay, what are these like basketball terms? If anybody who's just not like just sickos just watching every stream and every like there's
yeah.
Leg Up and Liam Murphy and just everybody, right?
Peter. These guys talk about whizzing all the time, man.
Dude, the funniest thing is the Pete Overs at the iHeart wide receivers and like the P font. I'm like, how many of those sold? Like, I need to see the numbers on that one. So yeah,
I love it. All right, so we are coming up here. We're good at QB, two running backs, six wide receivers. Drawn a blanket tight end so far, but I think we've got some fun options for later. Yeah. I see something.
Okay. Here.
We could have some correlation.
So QB definitely not.
Yeah.
Running back, I think, is definitely in play here. We have what, five wide receivers? Six wide receivers.
Six.
So
yeah.
Six. I mean, I don't love Judy or Shakir. I like Chuba.
Yeah.
Chuba, let's
see, correlates with.
I'm fine with Chuba. Just get some points.
Yeah.
What about tight end? Like,
yeah.
I mean, I don't love Cole Kmet, but he's fine. I think we push
him. Yeah. Come back for that.
Okay.
We have tight end at home.
Yeah, we definitely have tight end at home. And we have, we everyone and their mom knows we have our preferred late round tight end options. So
I love it. Don't take Chuba, please, guys.
Imagine saying that like a couple years ago. Don't take Chuba, like, please.
Oh my gosh. I love it. Yes. Kmet keeps falling because he's not great at football. I'm sorry.
You know what? We are setting ourselves up very well for a Bryce QB3.
Just because you can draft three QBs doesn't mean you should. you know, fire up the Michael Jordan. Stop.
Get help. Dude, I'm like, I'm very, very into Will Levis. Like, I just, I, you know what? It's crazy because I hated Will Levis. Like, I was like,
I know,
number one Will Levis hater on planet Earth. Like, coming in, I was like, this is a guy, he's not accurate. Like, he just has no, like, what is the point? Right. And then he fell to the second round. I'm like, okay, I'm not taking him in rookie drafts. I have no shares. And then you just see that succulent, that juicy, deep passing. You see you see D-Hop just running deep and just scoring three touchdowns in a game. And you see the comeback against Miami. Mm. So you get that, the scintillating upside paired with Brian Callahan, by all accounts, is the coach speak index on Twitter. If you've seen that, he's going to sling the rock. He's going to try as much as he can to throw that thing. They brought in Calvin Ridley, who, you know, he's not a superstar, but he's a very good receiver. I think people are underrating how good he was last year. He had a lot of drop touchdowns, right? And he wasn't the Calvin Ridley of old, but he's still solid. Maybe they draft it's probably tackle now at what is it, 8 or 7? Mm-hmm. It's probably tackle, but you know, they still could draft a receiver or Bowers or something there. I think that Bowers would be a super fun pick there. I'm not sure they would do that, but I would be down for it. Banish Chig to the shadow realm, please. And this, I think he's going to get a shot. I don't know. Like, I think for best ball specifically, if he's like your QB2 or QB3 with a strong QB for the two, like, is he going to be super consistent? I'm not sure, but I think he's going to have some very big games. Just the volume is going to be so much better. So yeah, that's my Will Levis rant.
It's quite a rant. And I can appreciate its depth and care. This is real gross.
Wicks. What about running back? I like Sharps or Jalen Wright.
Sharps or Wright? Which one?
I feel like Sharps.
Okay.
Okay, so then why don't you run through the squad really quick?
Yeah, so drafting the biggest boy. We've got Lamar and Tua at QB, friends of the show. Running back, Devon Achane, David Montgomery, Chuba Hubbard, and Zach Charbonnet. I think that is the most, like, H's, like, in a running back room that I feel like I've personally ever had. Like, we've got a Charbonnet, a Chuba, an Achane. It's very sneezy. I don't know.
It's very sneezy.
We've got Amon-Ra St. Brown, Jalen Waddle, Romo Dunes, Deontay Johnson, Xavier Worthy, and Jacoby at wide receiver. That cleaned up real nice. And tight end is a mystery wrapped inside of an enigma. But we'll figure it out. We've got time.
So why don't we sauce some of these other people's teams here. So let's see what Rusty's doing. He's got Garrett Wilson, Diggs, Neighbor. So he started off pissing. He got a fallen Josh Jacobs, who I think Jacobs is going to end up a second round pick. So don't mind him there. Pickens, and then Hollywood, Njoku, Jordan Love, Romeo Dobbs, Chase Brown, Aaron Rodgers to pair with Garrett Wilson, and then Musgrave to pair with Love. Okay, I like it. I like it so far. He's obviously a seasoned vet. I like it. He's building out some stacks.
Very thoughtful approach.
And then let's sauce our boy Gobbler really quick before we're on the clock. CMC, Rashee Rice, Mike Evans, and then he paired Rice with Mahomes. Stole our boy Zay Flowers, Kyle Schitts. Chris Godwin kind of filled out the wide receiver room, and then started hammering some running backs with Mostert and Javonte, and then Kirk. Did he have someone else with Kirk? No.
Pitts.
Oh, okay. There you go. I'm off my game. And then Muth at pick 144, and then Marvin Mims.
Yeah.
We got some, you know, this is a sharp room. You can tell.
Not a lot of layups available here for us. All right, so we're coming up. What do you want to do? Four running backs, six wide receivers, and we are drawn.
What about tight end?
So
Mayer?
I would be down for that. I think we've got a good double tap opportunity if it presents itself, kind of coming back.
Why don't you, you can speak freely. I don't, and we're going to be on the clock.
Yeah, I think I'm down for Mayer. And then maybe we can snag Likely on the way back.
Yeah, it makes sense for the stack.
Pick 162. So I think that's like 10 spots ahead of ADP for Likely, maybe.
Yeah, I say we like I like Jahlil and I like Marshawn Lloyd, but I think we got to go Mayer just to get our first tight end. Like this is the thin tight end room anyways. We're going to go three, but I think we got to go tight end here.
Yeah,
we can't, I dig it. Can't push it any longer.
Gosh, we're so pro tight end. And in our first, you know, spendy draft of the year, we just neglect the position entirely.
You got to take what the room gives you. And like, you just can't get locked out at wide receiver. Like, it's just so tough. Like, If we didn't go HN in the second round, then it would have given us a little bit more flexibility. But it's like once you set down the path, you kind of have, you set your path in stone. So
I love it. Fate has a fun way of dealing with you in these drafts.
It does.
Oh, there he goes, your boy, Will Levis, round 14.
Can we talk about Ricky Pearsall and his tattoo? Did you see that?
Bet on me. I love it.
Dude.
Let's have some fun.
It's crazy. Like, that was hilarious. Like, I feel like that's like, you like your wide receivers to be nuts. So I feel like I like that. Like, I feel like, yeah, I'm bumping them up a few spots in my rankings just because of that tattoo. So,
yeah, I mean, it's important that they have a little bit of an edge to them. So I dig that.
I mean, he's a white boy with a 42-inch vertical, so you know he's already high in my rankings personally, but that bumps him up even higher.
Yeah.
Yes, Rusty is also a Bulletproof Discord favorite, and he was on the channel probably about a month and a half ago. So go check out the episode with him.
I love it. I need to start getting some more Drake May in here and kind of ignoring those like mid round.
Best ball guy, shout out to best ball guy. Go check out his streams. But yeah, he says Michael McBride of 2024 Mayer. Yeah, I think Mayer is, this is a very good cost on me.
So do you want to go Likely here or do you want to do something else?
Scroll through really quick. Let's see what else we have.
Just at tight end or at everything?
Yeah. I kind of want a running back to be honest. I kind of like Rico.
All right.
That's okay. Honestly, we should probably have at least one stack with Baltimore other than Rashad Bateman.
With this tight end room, like, we're just hoping to kind of like rotate through whoever catches a touchdown that week. And I think we'll be all right.
So let's see, what are our picks coming up? Like, what are the pick numbers for the next?
We've got 175 and 186.
Okay. So we might be done. Yeah. I think we running back and running back and tight end. And then maybe Bateman or trying to think. Janu, did Janu already go? No, probably not.
Janu, no, is like 175.
Hunter Henry, he's not sexy, but I feel like he is fine. He had some big weeks.
I mean, it is a real shame that tight end is blue here and we don't get the like crank and purple drafting QBs here, but you know, it was just something so satisfying about just saying, you know, pulling the crack rock and cranking purple. It's good.
But we have our two tight ends now. Do we take, like, I almost feel like because we took them our first one around 13, we should instead of taking an 18th round guy or a 17th round guy, take one in the next two rounds and just right, like maybe someone falls to us here.
Yeah.
Running back also gets kind of gross. So probably, I think we have six pretty strong wide receivers. So I'd probably prioritize tight end and running back coming up. I think there's still some decent options, not amazing, but Keaton Mitchell, I just can't get on board, even on the stack. I just don't, it doesn't make sense to me. We could get a Justice Hill late. Maybe, like, I think he could be the RB2 with Henry and be the pass down guy.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
Otten keeps falling.
Yeah, so he's what, 10 picks past right now, but we don't have any Bucks. We do get some NFC South.
I don't really view Otten that much different than like this whole range of tight end. Like, what is the difference between Otten and Hunter Henry other than that he's younger?
So would you want to have Janu on this team? If you had to pick between Otten, Henry, or Janu, where would you?
I feel like I like Otten or Henry a lot more. I know for the correlation, but I'm just not sure, especially in this tournament versus like a BBM or something where it's a bigger tournament. Obviously, we still want to correlate, but I don't think it's as important. We already have Achan and Waddle. So
yeah,
I just feel like a Mayer likely Janu tight end room is pretty thin. Like that seems like, right, like likely could give you a lot of zeros. I mean, he has a kind of contingent upside, like weird tight end contingent upside with Andrews being hurt the last couple of years. But I wouldn't really bake on him as being a guy that's going to give you points every week. So if we only have Mayer, I'd lean towards Hunter Henry, even Juwan Johnson. Well, let's see. What are your thoughts on that? For like, do we go for the correlation or do we go for kind of Janu spike weeks?
So I go for the guy that's going to be probably one of the better target earners on his team. Henry's going to be one of the top options for the Pats, their offense.
Chat, roast us if we should go Janu. I feel like we should go Hunter Henry. I don't think like what was his name? Yeah. Durham Smythe. Like I know I think Janu's better than Durham Smythe, but like realistically, how many he'll probably have a few big spike weeks, which could just pay off his ADP, which I guess is the thesis most likely, but it's also just like, I feel like Hunter Henry is going to give you more floor and the same ceiling. So why would I take the chance on it other than just correlation? So,
yeah, I dig it. Very well reasoned. I thought I was waiting for it because the whole time as you were approaching like the climax of your soliloquy, I was just waiting for them to just draft Hunter Henry, like right there.
And I was thought it was going to happen.
Cut your legs out from underneath you.
It'd be great. Okay, so let's run through the let's figure out our last three picks here.
Okay. Well, we've got four.
Oh, fuck it. Okay, it is 20 rounds. Okay, I was like, thank God.
Or five. I can math. This is good.
Okay, that makes me feel a lot better. So
we've got two QBs, four running backs, six. Now I can't read. Six wide receivers and three tight ends.
Okay. Running back. We're done at tight end. We're not taking four tight ends.
We can't make you.
Pull up running back. This is also very gross.
Yeah, we're going to be... So either we start breaking ADP.
I think we're fine to break ADP now. I don't care
about
ADP at this point. I don't. Do you want to go? I mean, yeah, I don't. None of these guys really stand out to me. Herbert, I like, but like, I don't know if I really want him to be a priority.
I mean, we could just crank the shit out of tight end right here and get John. But I don't know. Do you want to go Khalil Herbert or Bateman?
My gut says Herbert. I just don't know that the correlate. Like, I don't know. I'm going against correlation again, but I just don't. think the running back gets so gross. And then
yeah, let's do it. He's, you know what, fire up that Wolf, because that's 10 spots behind ADP.
Khalil Herbert, RB3. I don't know about that. Like, I just, okay. First of all, I know Swift got the money, but like, do we really trust Swift?
Not at all.
Number two, do we think Roshan is that good? Like, I think he has a role. He's fine. He's an NFL player. But like, I think Herbert is pretty good. Like, I don't know. Like, and maybe he gets cut if they don't want to, right? If they don't want to have three guys in that backfield.
Yeah. And I would imagine the market would be pretty intense for a sixth round running back that had trouble staying on the field. So we got that to worry about. But yeah,
true.
I think he's a good runner. I think Roshan definitely brings more to the table in terms of pass catching ability. And, you know, every coach's favorite third down blitz pickup, you know, pass blocking snaps at running back is what you want.
I think Herbert, especially this late, like versus some of these other guys in that are going this range, I just think he's actually good. Like, just default to the talent of like,
yeah,
we don't know the situation, but like, if one guy gets hurt out of those the other two, then I think he will give you some usable weeks. So
I want to know what it is about Herbert, because there's something that you have come across somewhere, some form of media, an article, a video, whatever.
Just
like
Herbert.
Anytime, dude, I feel like it's like every stream where you're like, no, Khalil Herbert's like a good running back and we need to take Khalil Herbert. And it's like, it's evergreen content at this point. I appreciate it. I've got my guys. I think you've caped more for Khalil than you have like
pretty much any other player.
It's great.
Oh no, Gary took Bryce Young. Oh no.
Son of a gun. How about J.K. Dobbins?
Great. Dude, I can't get on board.
His job.
I used to be a J.K. Dobbins guy. I you know what? I had sent a first in Dynasty for J.K. Dobbins, a 24 first for J.K. Dobbins right before the season, like on a team where I was like, okay, I just need an anchor running back. And then,
yeah,
and I think he would have absolutely smashed. I will die on that hill that he would have. If Gus Edwards,
man,
and Justice Hill and Keaton Mitchell were smashing, then J.K. Dobbins would have gone bonkers.
Yeah, he has had the worst injury luck, but you know, been fun to watch when he's healthy, man. Like, he's a great running back. I hate it for him. Like, I think he's one of those guys that you would love to see what that offense could have been with him and Lamar together, fully healthy, just crushing it. So we are going to have the chance to do something fun and fire up the value hound again if you want to do it.
There we go. Okay, so why didn't you tab the wide receiver? Why don't we put Bateman in the queue? But
okay,
Let's just see what our other options are. Because I, like we said, scroll the F down. I don't think there's too many. Like, I kind of like Hyatt. But what are your thoughts? Do we just do it? So we got him in ADP value. Just take Bateman and just move along.
Yeah, I'd say we give him a shot.
Okay. Rip.
Yeah, and we can be done at wide receiver. We did a thing. We didn't leave Lamar naked and afraid.
We'll get a second one coming in.
Oh, shit. Here we go again.
We can't quit. It's like a nicotine habit. We just can't quit Rashad Bateman.
No, man. I am, what's her name, from 50 First Dates. Drew Barrymore, just wake up every day and I will fall in love with Rashad Bateman all over again. Like nothing ever happened. It's great.
What could go wrong?
It'd be great.
I mean, at least he's not going at pick. We were drafting him, what, like pick 90 last year? Like,
yeah, real high.
And I was a Bateman over Zay Flowers guy, which in hindsight just seems absolutely awful. But
yeah, I was guilty of that too. That's tough. That's a tough scene.
I know
he's another one, man. Baltimore's got too many what ifs or what could have beens lately. I don't like that. You know,
I know Tyler was a Bateman guy as well. So we're all over here in the corner crying, but you know.
Like a Patrick Bateman clip we can play. That might have been a few years ago when the hype was
a master Bateman clip.
All right. We're seven away. Let's see what's Rusty been up to lately? What kind of shenanigans? Rusty. Jaleen McMillan, Roshan, Audric Estime. Love the Estime pick. Marshawn Lloyd, Ty Chandler. Man, it's in his bag right now. Mm.
Yeah, Rusty, he's a grinder. He knows his shit.
Yeah. All right, so we
AJ Dillon.
I was hoping Will Shipley would come back to us, but we lost that.
Foreman. Alexander Mattison, all these guys are kind of gross RB2 type guys.
Yeah, Madison's definitely gross, but we do get the Vegas stack with Jacoby.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I don't hate it. I don't hate Justice Hill later. Dylan, I don't think Dylan Lauby, this is the take. What about quarterback and wide receiver just quickly?
Russ.
Do we just go upside 3 QBs for this tournament and take JJ McCarthy?
Do we have any Vikings though?
No, but could be.
Let's do it.
Could be Vegas.
Yeah, let's live a little. First time to get McCarthy. We'll wait till the biggest board. I love it.
I mean, I don't think we needed a third QB, but we have seven wide receivers and the first six are pretty strong. We have three tight ends. We have what? Two more picks.
Yeah. And we can just
go RB, RB.
Yeah. And yeah, Dylan and Madison go right after us too. So.
Of course.
Yeah, that's how it goes. It's great. Oh, man. So what are your – oh, go ahead. Sorry.
No. I'm not doing shit. I'm just chilling.
I was going to start getting into, like, QB landing spots that you want to see happen, you know, since that seems to be the talk of the week with everybody kind of catching up to – McCarthy going in the top 10. So I was curious, you know, like what do you see for your favorite spots for the guys?
Yeah, I just really like May. Like I mean, that's not a spicy opinion based on what I've seen in the industry, but seems like he's going way too low in best ball. And I think there's a chance just he falls a little bit in rookie drafts as well, which I would be very, very happy about. I still think he could go to Washington. I don't know why the Daniels steam is so strong. I feel like people are just assuming that Daniels goes there, but I think it's pretty much 50-50 chance. If I were Washington, I would take May. But I think so. Yeah, and then Daniels to the Patriots seems pretty bad. Just like drop a rookie quarterback in that environment seems pretty terrible. So. I almost feel a little bit better just about May going to the Patriots and just kind of like, I just think he has a much more stable floor. It's still not a great situation, but Daniels, I just feel like if he doesn't have the team around him, like from a real life perspective, it just could be pretty bad for him. Maybe for fantasy this year, it would be fine, but like long-term speaking, I just don't see it being great. Rome is just, I think MHJ is going to go the first out of the three receivers. But after that, I would not be surprised if Rome goes higher than Neighbors, just based on everything I'm seeing from all the draft guys, from like pretty much everyone just loves Rome. I mean, we saw his reception. Obviously I still would take Neighbors from a fantasy and real life perspective, but I think it's definitely on the board that Rome could go above. So Rome to the Cardinals would be fun, or neighbors to the Cardinals would be fun. Giants, if Rome is there, I think that would be a pretty good spot for him, and just give them that alpha outside wide receiver. But I think Bowers to – I still think Bowers to the Titans would actually be a pretty good fit. Like, just give Will Levis all the weapons, and then if he does fail, you can just get someone else. So do we go –
Yeah, this is what I'm going to sell you on. Deontay Foreman and the Nick Chubb role, because Nick Chubb's not going to be playing until later in the year. And what's his name? He's not a good running back.
Can't remember. I'm fine with that.
Yeah. Cincy guy, what was his name?
Jerome Ford?
Jerome Ford. Thank you. My gosh. Sometimes. Yeah.
Who do we want for this last running back? Do we go Tank? If Tank Bigsby falls, I feel like I don't love it, but I would be no.
No. I'm good on that. Like,
what about Zeke back to Dallas?
I think there are worse clicks here than that.
Steph is the resident Cowboys fan. She was hyping up Brooks to the Cowboys because the team doctor did his ACL surgery. Steph, what do we think about is Zeke gonna sign back with the Cowboys? What's the news on that? She hates Zeke. Yes, we know. I think of course you hate Zeke. That makes sense. I appreciate that. But do you think it's actually a possibility? Like, I just have no read on that at all. I don't know if any beat writers or anybody.
Is talking. Rusty gonna take his guy Kamani Vidal? Here is
yes, of course he is.
Yeah, I'm excited to see this happen.
Rusty, come on. You're going to do it. How much you want to bet? I bet he does.
Oh, you know what? Speaking of scrolling the heck down.
Oh, man, I can't justify that. Oh, he went Izzy. Okay.
All right.
Steph says it's a possibility every day he isn't signed. Shout out to Steph. She's doing the leg up dynasty ranks. She said every Monday. So go. Sacrilegious is with leg up as well. So if you guys aren't already subscribed, it's some of the best content in the industry. And yeah, very, very, very sharp all around with Steph, with Pat, with Sacrilegious. Yeah. Definitely check them out if you're not.
Rusty, this is really disappointing, man. You had the chance. We didn't do it.
You're not sticking to your guns, the Kamani Vidal guns.
So I am a little how dumb is it to take four tight ends here? I mean, that's like suboptimal, right?
I feel like we shouldn't.
Okay. Can't believe I just asked that question and people.
No, I mean, no, you know what? No, it's not crazy. I was thinking about it earlier. I was thinking about it earlier.
So it's so gross.
Quickly, let's see, because we have seven receivers with Bateman. So I think Zeke is actually a fine pick here.
Right.
What about wide receiver? Dude, I can't do it.
So hard.
It's your account, so I will lean to you.
We're here for a good time, not a long time.
I think
time.
Palmer, Bourne, or OBJ are also defendable clicks.
Close out with Zeke. Let's just get some cheap points. Whatever. Gosh, it's fine. All right, hype this team up. Run us through. Here we go.
Okay, so we got Lamar stacked with. The Giga stack with Isaiah Likely and Patrick Bateman, Rashad Bateman. We got Tua stacked up with Achan and Waddle. We got JJ McCarthy stacked up with maybe Las Vegas guys, Jacoby. Achan, the kind of high floor, low ceiling guy, paired with Montgomery, who's the stable relationship type. We have Chuba Hubbard, Zach Charbonnet, Khalil Herbert, Deonta Foreman, and Daddy Zeke. And then we have Amon-Ra, Jalen Waddle, Roma Dunes, Deontay Johnson, Xavier Worthy, Jacoby Myers, and Master Bateman. And then we have Michael Mayer, Likely, and Hunter Henry. I feel pretty good about this team. I feel like it, obviously, like, the once you get past, like, round, what, like, 16, like, it gets pretty gross all around. But I feel like we closed it out well. We covered off each position. Tight end obviously is pretty weak, but I mean, does it really matter? Like Likely obviously has a contingent upside. Mayer, we're looking for the year two bump from him, and Hunter Henry can still give you. We saw in he two touchdown games, and they don't have that many receivers right now, so he's probably like the number one target, number two target until. If they draft MHJ, maybe, but
yeah, it's weird because it feels like a very safe team, you know. Like, but that's kind of what you, maybe not necessarily what you want in this structure, but because what is it? Four move on, and then it's two, and then one, right? Yeah, so I dig it. I think we've got a good chance. Like we've got difference makers at QB, we've got difference making wide receivers and a difference making running back. So I think we have enough ways to kind of elevate ourselves above the crowd, which is good. And then we kind of played it safe with some of the mid to late round wide receivers, scooped up some value where we could. I low key really enjoy the Bateman pick and the Deonta Foreman pick. I feel like he's like one round on Twitter away from like jumping up maybe like four or five rounds when people realize that like Jerome Ford is not going to be getting as many touches and Foreman is really good running between the tackles and outside as well. Like I think he's a perfect fit for what the Browns are gonna kind of want to do with that offense in terms of running the ball.
Yeah, I think like I've said it probably every stream as well, along with my Khalil Herbert love, but Deonta Foreman also, like, he just was in like 2 years in a row in Carolina. When given the opportunity, they'll give him 25-30 carries in a game. Last year I think he had one game with like whatever, 30 carries and like 25 points or something. I think we've seen the Browns, their offensive line is good. And Nick Chubb has succeeded. Pretty much every running back has succeeded there when they're given the chance. And I still think he's pretty good. So yeah, I like it, especially whatever, 19th round pick.
Yeah.
If he gives you one 25 point game, then he pays off his ADP. And that's all we're hoping for. In the playoffs.
You want to pump Rusty's team real quick?
Oh, we'll pump. Okay, so we got Garrett Wilson, Diggs, and Neighbor. So starting off pissing. Like we said, we got Jacobs for the Green Bay pick right there, pick 38. I feel like that's a pretty good price for Jacobs still. So definitely fine with that. Pickens at pick 59 is perfectly solid. Marquise Brown. Pick 62, also solid. Njoku pick 83, I like it. And then we got Jordan Love with Jacobs for the Green Bay stack, paired with Dobbs. Then we got a guy who's getting pretty steamy on Twitter with Chase Brown. Aaron Rodgers to pair up with Garrett Wilson, Musgrave to pair with Love, Ty Chandler, Marshawn Lloyd, and Estime. So a good mix of kind of RB2 types and some rookies for some upside. Jalen McMillan, I actually really like. He's from Washington. He's a rookie wide receiver. That wide receiver room is pretty crazy. It's McMillan, yeah. O'Dunes, and then who's the third guy? It's I can't remember his name. But like I think we could look back and be like, all these guys were really good. And pick 203, that's very good price on him. Think he could go probably third round, but maybe second round. He was injured, so Rondale Moore, it's fine. I mean, we'll see what other guys. I feel like I would prefer Jalen Hyatt over Rondale Moore, but like I'm not gonna not going to push back too much on that.
Yeah.
Izzy for the Jets, that makes sense. And then Tucker Kraft to handcuff yourself in the 20th round with the Green Bay tight ends. I think it makes sense, though. It does make sense to do that.
The tight end lockup, tight end secure. It's good.
I actually don't. I don't mind it. I think that's a pretty fun team.
Yeah.
And then you want to go through to Gobbler's team.
Yeah. So starting off out of the one slot, going chalk, real brave, CMC, and then Rashi Rice, Mike Evans. Got Mahomes to stack with Rice, which is really nice. Zay Flowers and Kyle Pitts. And then Godwin going with Evans. So some nice correlation there. Mostert and Javonte and Cousins to go with Pitts. Lad McConkey and Pat Freiermuth. Ray Davis, Malik Washington, J.K. Dobbins. Brendan Rice, so we've got multiple Rices on the team. Bo Nix and Theo Johnson to close it out at tight end.
He's the Raz God from the combine.
Yeah, it's good stuff. That's a sharp room. Not a lot of edges that we.
I was going to say this is a very sharp room. Obviously, $100 kind of raises the stakes, mm-hmm. and obviously because that's what it is, high stakes. Okay, Ben R. Which team was Ben R again?
I think he's Benny Boo here out of the 12 slot.
Oh yes. Okay. Let's see here. So started off testosterone heavy with the running backs, Jahmyr Gibbs and Kyren Williams. And then we got DK Metcalf, Kupp, and Brian Thomas at pick 60, Calvin Ridley. So he caught up at wide receiver after going running back heavy, so I like that. We got the leg up favorite, Jalen Warren, who's actually going to be the RB3 in Pittsburgh now with Arthur Smith's boy coming over. We got Jake Ferguson and Dalton Schultz. So covering yourself off at tight end there. I like that. Caleb Williams. Okay. And then stacked him up with Cole Kmet there. That makes sense. So covered off your three tight ends. And then we got Shahid, Ricky Pearsall, Will Levis, Malachi Corley, Noah Brown, and then who's his last round pick there? Will Shipley, Daniel Jones, Darius Slayton, and Justice Hill. So wait, who are his – why don't you pull up his actual team because I feel like I'm losing track of
– Yeah, there's
– So he has Caleb, Levis, and then Daniel Jones. Okay. That's a perfectly cromulent wide receiver room – or, I mean, quarterback room. I like that. Then we have Gibbs, Kyren, Warren, Shipley, Justice Hill. I feel like since you went two running backs first two rounds and then Warren top 100, I feel like it's fine to go five there. Probably would still prefer six, but it's fine. You have some three strong guys. Then you have DK, not stacked, Kupp, not stacked, Brian Thomas. Ridley is stacked. Shahid, Pearsall. So, I mean, I like your wide receivers. I think I probably would have wanted a little bit more stacking there. And then you have Ferguson, Schultz, and Kmet with only Kmet stack. So, I like it. I feel like the players I like. Only thing is the stacking, which it's not as important in this contest versus like a BBM or a bigger field contest. So, probably more defensible. So, it's probably just my me being used to the BBM type contest. So yeah, I like it. It's the construction is good. And yeah, just maybe slightly more correlation, but it doesn't always fall to you. So,
I want to tip my hat to this one, a weak land, Jefferson, Marvin and Debo. Pretty ridiculous. And then you put your foot on their throat with Derrick Henry. But could have had O'Dunes instead of Mixon. And then you come back to Kittle. Like, that's pretty ridiculous.
Yeah. Mixon going pick 54 is wait. Isn't his ADP like 70 something still? Like, I actually do like Mixon this year in just kind of like soaking up volume type role in Houston. But not that far ahead of ADP, especially if you took Henry.
Yeah,
no, he's moving up, so it's not crazy, but I still feel like that's whatever, around ahead of ADP. I don't think it's necessary.
Yeah, this team's, oh man, he cornered the market on Iowa tight ends.
Okay, so we got.
I knew I loved that team for a reason.
Yeah,
sorry.
Dylan Laub goes undrafted. What a travesty.
We had a chance.
Okay. Anybody else in the chat have any questions? Wanted you to sauce your teams. Anything? Any other breaking news that you want to cover, El Coach, before we head out of here?
Bro, just get us to the draft already. Like, I want the NFL draft year, man. I've been waiting long enough, getting teased by the prospect profiles, the mock drafts and stuff like that keep dropping. I'm just, just ready for it, man. It's going to be a fun one. How about you?
Yeah, I'm like I said, like I'm just trying desperately every day to not trade my first round picks for players, but it's like I'm just can't do it. I have to exercise discipline on that one. One question I do have for you is Dak Prescott. Did you see that they don't want to re-sign him. They're just going to let him play out his last year. What are your thoughts on that? Like, do you think it's just kind of the Cowboys being the Cowboys and they will end up getting something done, or where there's smoke, there's fire, there might be some interesting stuff going on there.
It's interesting. Cause they haven't signed Lamb to a deal yet either. So like, they're kind of just, it's a weird game of chicken to play, you think, with like two guys that are kind of the face of the franchise. I would imagine that they will get something figured out. Cause like, have they said like they're completely shutting it down for the rest of the off season, or he's just kind of going into it?
That's a very good question. Let me see. I didn't see the exact quote, so let me pull it up.
Cause yeah, like, I mean, Dak betting on himself is awesome because he's done that before and dude's earned it. I think he's, is he top five, like top seven QB comfortably in the league? Definitely like top three in the NFC. Incredible guy. And if he, like, the noise around the team is going to intensify if he doesn't sign this deal. Cause you've got some stuff around, like Tua hasn't signed a long-term deal in Miami yet. So I'm sure people would, continue to push that one. Rodgers, kind of real shaky ground with New York Jets. So I'm sure that would be a fun get for them if they can, tickle Dak away from the Cowboys. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, if Dak is available and I'm an NFL team, I'm definitely throwing in the bag and doing whatever I have to do. Like, fantasy, obviously he doesn't rush as much anymore, but like real life quarterback, like Dak is very, very underrated in my opinion. Like, can you imagine him in Miami with Hill and Waddle and
H? It's kind of a downgrade at QB if we're being honest.
I'm trying to think who else. I mean, yeah, to the Jets, imagine Garrett Wilson with,
oh my gosh. Yeah, he would just have the CeeDee Lamb, obviously not to that extent, but yeah, like,
I mean, who knows though? I think if his quarterback was Dak, I don't think I would put a ceiling on Garrett Wilson. Like he's been absolutely insane in the with the quarterbacks he's had. So yeah, if I'm the Cowboys, I am not even, it's just like Steph is saying, it's weird to not get it locked up.
I feel the same way. It makes no sense. And they found him in what, third, fourth round? Like,
I think it was third round. Yeah.
Yeah. There are teams that like go decades without having the answer at QB. Like, we're about to see if the Bears can finally do it. And it took, the other, like the, a team that they got the number one pick from completely like self-destructing in order to get another 101 for them to have this opportunity. And their fan base is like legitimately like split on it, which is insane. But like, it's hard as hell to find a QB, man. Once you get a good one, don't let him out of the room. Like, keep him there. You can play hardball with a lot of positions, but like, I would not mess with that.
The grass is not always greener. Lions were lucky to have Stafford, and I think people, it's weird. It's weird. You take it for granted, right? Like, obviously, like, the quarterback takes the blame, like, most of the time. Quarterback and head coach take the blame, but like, obviously it wasn't Stafford. We saw once he left, right? Like,
yeah,
he was one of the top quarterbacks in the league. And I think Dak, I think he is like on the Mahomes, whatever, Josh Allen, that type of level? No, but not, there's only so many Mahomes and Josh Allens, right? Like, they still have a shot if he's your quarterback to,
yeah,
make it to the Super Bowl, right? Like, if you surround him with good talent. Yeah, man, I don't get it. I don't get the Dak hate. Like, I understand he's had some bad games in the playoffs, but like, you got to look at it from the big picture. Yeah. So
their defense was also getting absolutely shredded by the Packers. Like, some of those plays, you could not have guys more wide open. Like, that was ridiculous. I would like to get your thoughts on the possibility of the Chargers trading away Justin Herbert. This stuff is so insane. I get it. Will probably, as I, you know, you say it out loud, it seems so insane, but like, it kind of feels like there's a chance that they're just completely clean in house.
I've been the number one Khalil Herbert supporter. I'm also the number one Jim Harbaugh hater. Like, I don't think there's a human being on the planet that hates Jim Harbaugh more than me, to be completely honest. Both my parents went to Michigan State. I'm a Michigan State fan. I did not go to Michigan State. But I just, that would be the most dunce move of all time. I'm sorry.
Like, yeah.
It just, that would set your franchise back 10 years immediately. And I don't care if there's a difference in rookie contract between, right? Like, that's the one thing you could,
that would be the ultimate like analytics. Like, oh, the argument would be great. I just fire up the Eli Cash. Like, you know what this conversation presupposes is that, look, everyone knows that Justin Herbert is the quarterback for the Los Angeles Chargers. What this conversation presupposes is maybe he isn't. You know,
I mean,
great.
If I'm any team, if I'm right, the Vikings, if I'm the Raiders, if any team is like, has a chance in hell to do that.
Yeah.
I am moving every possible player and pick I can do to do that. Like,
yeah.
Like, imagine him on the Vikings with Jefferson. Oh my gosh. And Hawk and Addison, like, that would be insane. And that coaching staff too, that throws the ball, right?
Yeah.
I don't get that one. JJ, where you were asking me about landing spots. Like, where do you think JJ is going to end up? It seems like Minnesota, based on the moves they're making, and they have the ammo to do so, but ultimately where do you want him to end up, and where do you think like are the spots that he actually could end up?
Yeah. I think Minnesota is seeming like the likeliest pick, with them getting the Texans. I think, what is that, like the 22nd or 23rd pick?
Early 20s. Yeah.
Kind of loading up there. I think that's the one that everyone, you know, kind of wants to see. It makes sense. I think having Darnold there gives them, you know, a chance to let him chill for a bit, let him develop from the bench. I think KOC has plenty of job security there as the head coach. Like you called out, a lot of fun weapons there, man. Like, you've got JJF, Addison, Hawk. There's a lot of cool ways for that offense to break right. The Raiders, it's weird that the Raiders are so quiet right now. And they even kind of came out, was it the head coach, Pierce, that came out and was kind of touting AOC a bit and saying that it was
oh really, I didn't see that,
his team or so. I don't know, I thought I saw that, which would seem weird because they just signed Minshew too. So yeah, could see it with Vegas. I think they're another team that has like a pretty fun offense where you've got, you know, Devontae, you've got Jacoby, Michael Mayer at tight end. So there's some weapons there. I don't know, man. And like you saw some stuff today about Washington possibly like entertaining Emmett too. And I think that's a bridge too far. Like everybody's, I don't know why everybody's so down on May right now, because that dude's a stellar prospect. A lot of fun to watch, was, you know, just got an incredible arm, got some mobility and stuff like that too. Huge guy. Like we've sung the praises of May before. So yeah.
Yeah. No, I mean, I do think Minnesota is the most likely based on what we've seen. But yeah, Tyler was saying Las Vegas is a dark horse. Broncos, I'm not sure like if they have the ammo, but they could be a dark horse. But I definitely think someone is going to trade up. Probably one of those three. And it's just, yeah, it's an exciting time of year right now. I'm just really excited to, like we said, rookie drafts are this is a crazy class. Like, I know we say that every year, but like truly, if you look at just the prospects available, and especially the guys that are going to get pushed down the board into the second round, right after that top 7-8, if we get JJ in the top 10, like you said, the whole first round is going to be first round picks, right? Which almost never happens. Usually the only thing I'm worried about is running backs. Just people always, I feel like someone will take a running back like really earlier than you think, just because they need a running back. I mean, anything can happen in a rookie draft. I had Bijan fall to me at 104 last year. So never count out that crazy shit can happen. But I'm really excited. Let's see what else is going on.
Do you think if you were the Cardinals and someone came to you with an offer to move out of the fourth pick, but either you draft Marvin Harrison Jr. or Neighbors, or you get like two firsts basically to move back. Like with what you've seen for that type of profile at wide receiver over the years, where, you know, those top five guys like Chase, like AJ Green, everyone comps Marvin to AJ Green. Like, do you trade out of that, or the coaching staff and GM seem really supportive of Kyler? Do you kind of like give him that elite weapon there and not trade out of it, not do the value hound thing to scoop up more draft capital and just take what many people are calling like the best player in the draft there?
I mean, that's a tough one. I mean, I think personally, I'm trying to think, get into the mind of an NFL GM, but I feel like if it depends on what the offer was, but if you're saying like, if it's like an extra first and then maybe like a second or something on top for someone to trade up, which I feel like usually that's a route, right? It's usually about that to move into the top four, right? Four or five. I feel like I'd have to take the picks, but maybe that's just my dynasty brain kicking in. I don't think you can really go wrong there though. Like, right. Like Marvin Harrison is pretty much as locked in as a prospect as you can possibly get. Personally, I would take the picks, but I think either one is defensible. Tyler was saying Dak. Yeah. Why trade up for QB4 when Peyton can simply sign Dak to future? I mean, that would be very fun. Dak, Herbert, Mahomes, all in the same division.
That would be fun. Also, the Broncos can, you know, just chill that half, like, just chill out from, you know, falling ass backwards into great QBs that run into weird contract issues. That would be cool. Like, you know, just kind of stop doing that. We'll never forgive them for the making, like, just the Peyton Manning thing gets on my nerves to this day, where he's like all over the place in Bronco orange. It's tough.
It is. Yeah.
that's my cool, irrational, like, Homer take. I also, I don't, I'm not here to grind any axes, but what has Sean Payton done in Denver at all? Like, it just seems like a complete disaster. So, I mean, yeah, if he's got to get bailed out by the Cowboys not re-signing Dak, that's how he saves his job. Whatever.
Yeah, he's riding the coattails of the Super Bowl he won. What was it, 12 years ago? No, I forget what year it was, but
bro, if you could just stop bringing up moments where the Colts lose in big games in the playoffs, that would be great.
I'm just taking the dagger and just digging it deeper.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Who calls an onside kick coming out of halftime? Jeez, what a genius.
2010.
Yeah, gosh.
Threw
a couple of cases of Miller Lite for that game.
Need some brewskis. Let's see. One sec. Let me remove this. And let me share my screen. Someone is asking me to sauce their team really quick.
What do you want me to pull up?
No, I have it, but it's not letting me share my Discord screen. So one second. Let me see if I can pull it up over here.
Yeah, I don't like this. The Dak vibes to the Broncos, please stop. Broncos deserve nothing. Terrible fan base.
Sorry if this is very hard to see. But this is someone's, who is this? Someone sent this to me and just asked me to sauce them. Okay, so we have Mahomes at pick 63. Which is pretty wild. I think you got to take him at that point. Stafford paired with Puka. You have Mahomes paired with Marquise Brown. So you got a stack there. Kamara at value. Pollard at a value. Javonte at a value. Herbert at a value. Damian Pierce is never a value. So, and then you got MHJ a little bit early for my liking, but we've talked ad nauseum about MHJ. It's like you still want some shares of them. Waddle, Cooper Kupp paired with Stafford as well. So you got Puka and Kupp right there, which is nice. Gabe Davis, he's perfectly defensible pick, whatever. It's like he's going to give you a couple spike weeks probably. And then Malachi Corley, and then four tight ends. It's fine. I mean, you already have six running backs and pretty strong running backs. I would say the Tony and the Tony Chig and Davis Allen picks, like unstat, and Darren Waller pick 150. I don't know when this is from. It's probably from a while back.
Two-time Super Bowl Kadarius Tony. Let's put some respect on that man's name.
Do you get fantasy points for Super Bowls? I didn't know that.
Sure do.
I mean, overall, I think obviously Mahomes stacked and Stafford stacked is nice. You got some good, this is back when Jacobs was going, yeah, so this is a while back. So you still got some good running back values though, but ADP wise, solid enough, pretty solid wide receiver room other than, I guess, Tony, but he is stacked. So whatever, maybe last round pick. And then, yeah, don't love Chig or Davis Allen, but whatever. You punted tight end, so it's fine. Yeah, it's a good team. You got a lot of ADP value, which makes it look a lot better. And yeah, looks good. No, oh, is it that small? I'm sorry,
dude. It was very, very small. I could not see it, but I'm impressed. Like you were navigating through it fine. You didn't have to put your readers on. It was great.
Yeah, only one. I do wear glasses sometimes. But only like if I feel like it, like I have one eye is fucked up and the other eye's fine. So then it just, your body adjusts, you know, the human body is very, it adapts. All right, everyone. Well, we have been rambling for a little bit, so we will, end it off here, but, El Coach, thanks so much for, hopping on and ripping $100 draft in March. You know, I appreciate you. And everyone be on the lookout for El Coach. He will have his channel popping up getting ready to draft some BBMs. So be on the lookout for that. And we have Liam Murphy, winner of BBM 2. He was supposed to be Friday. We might move it to tomorrow. So I will tweet that out when I confirm that. But have him, and then I'll be on the lookout hunting for some more big guests. So be sure to tune in, like, subscribe. Only 35% of the viewers on our last couple of videos have been subscribers. So definitely that helps out the channel and helps us grow and get even bigger guests on. So thanks so much, El Coach. And any closing words for us?
Bro, thanks for having me on. As always, always fun to draft with you, bounce ideas back and forth. I appreciate it. I like our team, and just thanks for having me on, man. This is great stuff.
Have a great week, everyone. And we will see you either tomorrow or Friday. I will follow my Twitter and I will let you guys know.